speak on it.
Listen, I hate miserable situations. I hate for me to be in any type of aura, any room, and feel like my energy is just zapped. That's a problem for me. So to be in a relationship of any sort, whether family, whether friends, whether intimately with somebody, that's something I can't do long term. Especially as a loyal person, you find yourself accommodating for people. You find yourself constantly in a situation like, let me see what I can do for them. They work all the time. Let me see, you know, maybe we should take a vacation, you know, because if you just keep working, you're going to be insane after a while. Now, if a man don't work, he don't eat. You know, I got to work, nose to the ground, ain't no days off. Now, 10 years later, you're still in the same routine and you're accumulating money and bills and you've done nothing with your life. And you were not satisfied until you made the woman you were attached to, who's full of life, now lifeless and mummified. I refuse. My purpose is way too big to be attached to miserable people and things. I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. I'm not doing that anymore. Because sometimes as a loyal person, it's easy to become enslaved to things. You're accommodating. You're harmonious. You want everybody to be happy. But you better know your happiness is top tier as well. And we find great joy, even if it don't yield you a great amount of money, when you are fulfilling your life's purpose. Sometimes going out there and reading to the elderly people, sometimes going out and volunteering at a daycare or something like that just helps you. You be like, I feel so in touch with who I am. This is who I am. But at the same time, you can never get your spouse to support you in the things that are supposed to be purpose filled in your life. No. Anything that I'm doing with you is draining the life out of me. But anytime I want you to come live a little with me, now it's a problem. You got families like that too. Some people love to travel. You're just the light of your family. You're very different. It don't even really seem like you come from amongst these people. You're different. You always on that road. You better be careful. You always going somewhere. And y'all always going nowhere. You see that? Y'all always going nowhere. I'm not finna sit in this house and die with y'all, period. No, I'ma let the dead bury the dead. Y'all dead up in here. I got to go. This is miserable. And for some of you, you haven't gained enough strength and boldness to tear yourself away from these situations. Because you don't understand, anybody who is leading a life of misery will cause you to be miserable. You got some friends out there. It doesn't matter. It could be high energy. It could be the best situations. Man, why y'all always got to be so loud, man? Why y'all got to be... It seems like, man, y'all always laughing, always doing all this stuff, causing this attention, man. You're not coming anymore. You're not being invited anymore, period. You're not. You're the problem. No, us laughing and enjoying life is not the problem. It's you, sir or ma'am. You're not coming anymore. You're not getting an invite. It's always some stuff with you when we go somewhere. We get everything. Don't be perfect. But God, dog, roll with the punches. You're throwing the punches. And I'm tired of rolling with you. I'm done. Nah, this ain't gonna work. No. You have to understand when your energy is being drained. And unfortunately, many people stay in relationships for a century. For a decade. And you don't understand that so much life. How many birthdays have passed when you say, I guess it's just another day. No, you talking like him. You like birthdays. Don't let nobody take you off of what you like. You like that. You like balloons and little surprise stuff. You like that. But you're accommodating. It's not so bad. You know, he just said we'll go to a little day. You don't like that. You don't like that. Stop accepting stuff you don't like to accommodate people. Stop that mess. You're going to be miserable. They're already dead. Why are you sticking to the dead? Because you don't want to be alone. Baby, I will walk alone before I walk in misery. No, I have to fulfill my purpose. There are some things in life, the smallest of things, that bring you the most joy. And when other people don't want to share in those moments with you, where you feel like you got to go enlist other people who you don't even have great of relationships with, but these people get it, then you're in the wrong situations and stuff got to shift. Time is slipping away. You're not getting any younger. We will never get today back, and that's a fact. Time is changing. Every day is a constant change. You got to get through your head. Am I going to stick to a person? Yes, I love this man. And for some men, yes, I love this woman. I don't want to be viewed as a failure, but I am depleted. I can't even hang out with my friends anymore. I can't even do my little stuff on Facebook Live, my little corny jokes, because she always, don't embarrass me. You always doing it. You doing too much. You're not doing enough. And that's the problem. When people ain't doing enough in their life, they always tell you you're doing too much. Get away from those people. If they don't feel good, if they're not boosting your energy, if every time you go around, you are depleted, you got to pipe down. Let me not be so loud. You know how they are. Let me go take off this lipstick because you know how they are. They always say I'm being extra. If you have to keep accommodating people who are miserable, you got to get from around these people expeditiously. Love you much. Mwah.